think about a contest between Ryan Lochte and Charlie Lydecker, a swim meet between the two of them?
Yeah.
Both of them, do you think that'll work? So I want to invite the old guy, my buddy, your buddy, Charlie Lydecker, our newest gold medal winner, Ryan Lochte, come up here and talk a little bit about what they envision might occur here sometime in late March, early April. Charlie!
I am old enough. Ryan's not old enough to know who Tanya Harding is and Nancy Kerrigan. And I can assure you I got connections. So Ryan better watch himself.
I'm going to beat him.
Sorry about the whole punk thing, you know, I was just joking. All right.
Don't worry, we'll set it in April.
So here it is, the head-to-head challenge between 24-year-old Olympic gold medalist Ryan Lochte and 45-year-old executive vice president and triathlete Charlie Lydecker. Let's take a look at some of the festivities before the race, an event brought to you by Stonewood Grill and Tavern. It all culminates right here at the Limoran Center on the campus of Daytona State College. These two amazing swimmers will race in the 200-meter individual medley. Now the IM features four swimming styles in one race, the butterfly, the backstroke, the breaststroke, and they finish it off with a freestyle race to the finish. Let's see how these two men match up. Ryan Lochte is a professional swimmer and at the age of 24 already holds world records, not to mention gold and silver medals from multiple Olympic Games. He hails from Port Orange, Florida, where he trained with his father, Steve Lochte, as his coach for many years. To give you a sense of his dedication, in 1 week alone, Ryan will be in the pool for 22 hours, swimming an astounding 60,000 yards. Charlie Lydecker, a hometown boy from Ormond Beach, Florida, might not seem like he could give Lochte a run for his money. But at 45, Charlie is in fantastic physical condition. This executive vice president at Brown & Brown swims over 10 hours a week, averaging about 31,500 yards, making him a true competitor and a challenge to beat in the pool. To prepare for this race, Charlie has been training with Ryan's father, Steve Lochte. Both Lochte and Lydecker are anxious to get this race underway, so let's head to the pool for Splashdown.
Marching out. Once again, we talked about Charlie's great credentials. Vice President right here of Brown & Brown, a wonderful supporter of our event tonight. National Lifeguard Champion, Alcatraz Champion, Ryan Lochte, world record holder. World record holder in the 200-meter backstroke. Olympic gold medalist. I'll say it again. Olympic gold medalist in the 200 backstroke. He has the American record in this event, US Open record. He is the fastest swimmer on earth in the 200-yard IM. Nobody has ever been faster than Ryan Lochte. Will he be able to maintain that dominance here tonight? I notice Ryan down there, he's shaking his head. No, Betty, he's got a job to do tonight. It's all about going to work. It's about dedication. And it's about not losing. Now, swimmers will get their caps on. Very important to get those on nice and tight. Both of them pull the cap up over the goggles. Both swimming with jammers tonight. You won't see a full body suit out of either one of them. Here's the whistle. Quiet for the start, please. Quiet.
We need quiet for the start. Quiet for the start for both swimmers. For both swimmers, we need it quiet for the start. This is the 200 IM. Two lengths of each stroke. Butterfly back, breast and free. Madam starter. What do you think, baby?
Quiet for the start. Quiet for the start.
Oh, we got a break. Got a break.
Wait a second. Stop the race. Stop the race. Wait a second. Charlie.
Charlie's got something here. What's going on?
Charlie Lydecker has.
Charlie?
What? Oh, he's got some more money.
He's buying more seconds.
Wait a second. Hold on. Hold on.
What did he say? Charlie.
$11,000 for what? What do you want for $11,000?
Hey, Lochte, you gonna take that from him?
What's the $11,000 for? You think you're gonna get something for it? Second, you're the boss.
Hey, do we give him more time?
You gotta do it.
Hey, step it up. Be a man. Here we go.
You heard him. All right. It's time to get serious now. Here we go. You do that.
Madam starter.
Quiet for the start.
Now you see a great stroke by Charlie.
Madam
starter.
Beautiful
butterfly. That's a great start. There it is.
There it is, Ian.
Almost 50 yards behind. Oh, that's a great leadoff by Charlie. Watch that stroke underneath. Now here's his weak stroke. He's already caught up by 25. Look at that underwater. What a beautiful underwater by Ryan Lochte.
Come on, Lochte.
Watch when he comes off this wall.
Come on, Lochte.
25 yards ahead. He went from almost 50 to 25 in a span of 50 yards. 22-2.
Come on,
the first 50. Uh-oh. I think Lydecker's in major trouble, guys. Major trouble.
Come on,
46, 47. All right, now.
Come on, Lochte.
This could be ugly here. This could be ugly. But the question is, did Ryan leave too much that first 100? He looks like he's hurting.
Get him up. Get him.
Now, Charlie's got the weak stroke. Watch Ryan when he comes off the wall. Maybe not up. Here comes Ryan Lochte.
He may get him at the end.
This is close, ladies and gentlemen. This is close.
117, 118. Ryan Lochte, turn it at the wall. Lochte may get him now. They're both going to flip at the same time. Does Lochte have enough at the end? Both at the same time. Look at Ryan Lochte's last turn. He's going to do it. Lochte's going to do it. Ryan Lochte.
In with a 149.
How about that? Another round of applause, Ryan Lochte and Charlie Lydecker.
I'm trying to get over to get a quick interview with these guys before they get out of the water. There's nothing worse than somebody sticking a microphone in your face right after you swam a race. But I want to try to get a comment. Steve, you get Ryan. I'm going to get Charlie first. Charlie, tell me what happened that first 50. I know you wanted it. When we talked earlier, you really wanted to try to put it out there on the 50 fly. How did you feel after that first 50?
I kept thinking I should have had more time with $11,000.
I don't think that $11,000 would have helped anyway, even if you did get a couple extra seconds. But you looked really strong in the breaststroke, one of those strokes that you felt like you were a little fairly weak at, but you looked strong in that. It looked like the freestyle might have hurt a little bit more than you thought it would.
You know, by the time I got to the freestyle, I was ready to pass out.
Well, you know, Charlie, you mentioned that $11,000. We can always, you know, take a five-minute break and maybe get up on the blocks and do it again.
You guys want to try to do that again?
Hey, Ryan, it looked like you were laboring a little bit there when you got into the second 25 of the breaststroke and the freestyle. How did that feel?
Not so good, Coach.
Not so good, Coach.
The last 25, when I flipped, I looked over and saw you. I wanted to smile at you and say bye. But.
Oh! Ooh! You know, Rowdy. You know, Rowdy, he mentioned that, and look at him. He's not really.
He's not even breathing hard. That's what makes me so mad.
You know, his shoulders aren't as red. Yeah, Charlie, you're not even red,
no?
though. What's up? I mean, you must be in great shape.
I actually was surprisingly tight when I got in. I think it's just the anxiety and racing against the fastest man in the world, who I think is super cool for being out here and supporting a good cause.
You know, Charlie just went under 210 and 200 IM, which is one of the fastest times in his age group in this country. Good job.
And we have a lot of friends from the community here, which is way cool. So I think it's just great that everybody from the community was out and out here supporting Daytona Beach College, so Daytona State College, I should say.
Ryan, I want to ask you one question. I know a lot of people are interested in this summer and how training's going, how you feel coming off of Beijing and going into the summer of the World Championships.
Well, after Beijing, I definitely took a break. It was probably the longest break in my whole swimming career, but I needed it. I needed to let my body rest, my mind. And, I mean, I started getting fat, and so I had to get back in the pool. So about 4 months goes by, I get back in the pool, and right now I'm training for Worlds in Rome at the end of the summer, so it should be a good Worlds.